Let me greet my colleague, Deputy Minister Bulalani Magwanishe, who's a new addition to the DTI team and a very welcome addition to the DTI team. Let me also greet, I don't know if she's here, I know she was going to come, the Chair of the Portfolio Committee on Trade and Industry, Joan Fubbs. I don't see that she's here. But also then, Ms. Lizeka Mocheka, who's the Divisional Executive of Agriculture and Agro-Processing Value Chain of the IDC, who's just spoken. Mr. Spencer Son, the Managing Director of Foods for Woolworths. Let me also greet and introduce my colleagues on the DTI who are deeply involved in this project. They include the Deputy Director General of the Incentive Development and Administration Division, Malebo Mabichi Thompson. And then also the other Deputy Director General who's here in charge of the Special Economic Zone and Economic Transformation Division, Sipo Zikordi. There are many other officials from the DTI who are involved in one way or another with this kind of project who are here with us today. And then I think I want to have a special greeting for our hosts, Ms. Fazili Ali, the Managing Director, but also her partners, Candice Stewart and Shereen Davids of this company. And I want to, in particular, thank you for inviting us to the launch of these new facilities, but also inviting us to an occasion which I want to try to use to underscore what it is that we meant when last year we announced that we were launching a Black Industrialist Program. This is, as I think has already been indicated by a number of speakers, this is 100% Black-owned and also 100% female-owned company, which has benefited from some of the support programs that we have as an IDC and as a DTI, and also from the Woolworths Supplier Development Program, has benefited from that. And I want to just start off by saying a few things. You indicated in my CV that we have been launched, we launched the rolling three-year industrial policy action plans. The current one we launched on May the 8th. And what is this? This is a set of actions which we take as government to support the industrialization of our country, because I think that we know that our future and future growth in our country lies in us moving up the value chain, becoming a more diverse economy, moving away from what colonialism defined us as, producers and exporters of primary products, and moving into a space where there is in fact more value in products, which is by transforming those products. That includes every kind of value chain you can think of. This particular case, we're talking about adding value to food products in the form of a processed food, which comes out of here, Petfood, in this particular case. But we've also been saying that we need to promote greater inclusivity as an element, I think, of social justice, as an element of meeting the expectations of the people of this country to participate more effectively in the economy. But even more than that, because that actually will be the basis on which we will be able to deliver higher levels of economic growth. And so I think that we became aware in the work that we were doing over the years that there are indeed a number of Black entrepreneurs who are willing to be and are in the industrial space, who are industrialists, but very often find themselves trapped in a particular level of industrial activity, and there's many, many ceilings which they need to crash through in order to reach the next level. And so we developed the Black Industrialist Program. I think our message in the Black Industrialist Program is that we want to see more people from the historically disadvantaged and excluded community of this country opting to take a course of contributing to industrial development as leaders, as entrepreneurs, as owners of businesses, as well as, of course, as workers, because jobs remain very critically important to us, but also as leaders, and that we want to try to elevate the scale of the participation of a number of black industrialists. And so we said, when we launched the program, let's set ourselves a target of trying to find the best that we could find with a target of 100. And let's try to support them to take them to the next level. Let's try to look for this, for them. And so the Black Industrialist Program has brought together an incentive from the DTI. It's brought together a number of partners from funding institutions, development funding institutions like the IDC, into a funding forum. There's a single channel for applications. And usually what we like to see is that in the different product offerings that come from the different participants in the funding forum, we can see a mixture that people can come in and say, this qualifies for the DTI incentive, this qualifies for the IDC loan facility, this somebody else can come in some other way as well. That's what we've been looking at. And a point that I think is easy to establish coming to a company like this is that actually what we've gone and put in place is a pretty rigorous process to make sure that the people concerned are actually industrialists. This is not an opportunity for me to give my friend, my comrade, someone who comes and knocks on my door and says, psst, psst, help me out, or goes to Malebu, or anything like that, and that we're giving you money and it's going to go into your car, your home, your holiday trips. It's not that. You have to establish that you actually are an industrialist, that you're taking personal risk, that you actually are owning and controlling the business that is applied. You're not fronting for somebody else. You've had to establish that. And once you establish that, then you get a support in the form of an incentive grant from the DTI and other kinds of facilities from the other participants, in this case from the IDC. And it is used to increase the competitiveness of your business. So in this case, when we walked around, we can see it was invested in equipment that is enabling this company to move from being a small enterprise into a medium enterprise, and that's exactly what this program is supposed to be about. That is what the Black Industrialist Program is going to mean. Now, one of the things we have in our budget vote on Tuesday, and I will announce the actual scorecard of how many we have supported then. But I can say for now it's over 40. We have supported over 40 black industrialists, and they are people like this that are genuine, real, productive sector entrepreneurs. Those are the people that we are supporting, and it's an opportunity, and I thank you for this, for us to showcase and establish that point, because I think that the public needs to know that. Secondly, I think it's very pleasing to see that a retailer and a prominent retailer like Woolworths is taking seriously the issue of localization as well as the issue of empowerment. Because if we are going to carry on importing things that we can as well make in South Africa, we are going to lose jobs in this economy. We are not going to achieve the levels of industrial development that we can have. And so we have been saying, and it's actually part of the, anybody who wants to come and approach a government department in the future now, in any sector, draw any of our incentives, will have to start showing that they are making a contribution to black economic empowerment. And on the new scorecards, we are saying we want to see a sub-minimum on supplier development, exactly because we can see that bigger businesses have a critical role to play, and they can use decisions about supplier development to the benefit of industrialization and greater inclusion of more black industrialists. And so this is not a case in the case with Woolworths where it's an obligation, but it's a business decision that you've taken. And I think my notes are telling me that you've done this because you have a less wastage by coming to the local supplier. You have less quality defects coming to the local supplier. You've got less of a need to hold high stocks of product by coming to the local supplier. And you've got the huge benefit now of the exchange rate of coming to the local supplier. And so it's a good business decision to come to the local supplier. And because you want to maintain your quality, you too have invested in the local supplier and making sure that the local supplier can meet the quality requirements so that people who walk into the Woolworths shop are satisfied that they can continue to have quality products. I think that kind of partnership, that's the lesson, that's the example that we need to build. So I think that at all levels, this is a wonderful project. We're very happy that we are supporting and have supported 40 enterprises like this. I will make it clearer on Tuesday, but I've said it before, that we've taken a decision. We said in 2016 when we launched the program, our target would be to support 100 quality black industrialists through this program. We said by the end of the medium-term expenditure framework period, that would have meant by March 2019. We've taken a decision that we will do it faster. We will reach 100 by the end of March 2018, the end of this financial year. That's because we think that this is a very, very important program. And so I think it just remains for me to thank the members of our team, Malebu and her team. They've been running this program. They've been adjudicating this process. They've been able to ensure that I can stand up and say, I'm satisfied that these are real, genuine industrialists that we are supporting, like this particular case, the leadership of K9. I'm also happy to be able to point to the partnership that we have with the IDC. In fact, the IDC is going to put in many more bucks than we are going to be able to put in, but it's a partnership. Everybody else is participating in the program from the other agencies of government. And to companies like Woolworths, I think that you need the kudos and the recognition that you're doing the right thing in this regard. And in particular to Madam Ali and her team, we just wish you well in this business. And I'm sure that the pets will enjoy eating your food at the end of the day. Thank you very much indeed.